Okay, so 3 points are in the bag with the first game of the season against Leicester. We've won two goals to one today. Not the best performance. I don't want to go overboard because it is the first game of the season, but you have to be honest, it wasn't great to watch at times. There was a lot of patterns of play that we saw from last season. First half, we started off really well. The place was absolutely rocking. So first of all, I do want to commend the fans on that. The atmosphere was brilliant. Nobody can accuse, especially after the lack of transfer activity over the summer and obviously what happened yesterday at deadline day, nobody can accuse the fans of being flat and deflated. They were up for it. There was debutants in there, obviously Pereira getting some game time as a first teamer, and obviously the likes of Fred starting and Pogba, captain P today. So we started on the front foot and the place was rocking, and it was good to see Pogba stick that penalty away nice calmly. It took about 2 hours to run up to the ball and actually stick it away, but he did. And we're 1-0, and then I'm thinking, do you know what? Place is rocking. We're looking like playing on the front foot. Fred was pressing, Pereira pressing, and we looked good. And then we just took our foot off the gas. I want to say it's down to rustiness, you know, players coming back off the World Cup, or you know, first game of the season, a bit of ring rust and stuff. I want to more put it down to that. But the reality is that there was a lot of those that performance that was similar to last year. Some of the fans did say it. So it's not about being negative. It's just about really analysing that game as a whole. Yes, the most important thing is the 3 points. But realistically, we didn't play well. Sanchez looked energetic. He looked like he was up for it. But then the kind of quality out of his game kind of left him. I thought Rashford was a little bit isolated up there today. One matter, again, he tried to get on the ball where he could, but kept cutting in and we didn't have that natural riff. I will say Fred, I thought he was pretty good today. Quite a lot of fouls. I saw Andre Mariner, don't get me started on ref, I don't think he had a good game at all. But I thought Fred had a good game. He had quite a lot of fouls, and he's going to get used to the Premiership. But I like that tenacity. I like the fact that he goes after people, snapping at their heels. You need that in the midfield. Pereira, I thought, was good. I thought his range of passing was good. He held onto the ball well in tight spaces. And Pogba tried. He huffed and puffed a bit. A good few little bits of play, a couple of good touches on the ball. But it was more of a team performance that wasn't quite there. I'm not really digging out individuals. We just allowed Leicester to have the ball, and I can't believe we've done that. First game of the season, especially with them going 1-0 down in the first, 3 minutes, their confidence should be down. I mean, I'd like to see us go for the kill, and people around me where I was sitting, they had the same reactions. They were sort of like, well, I can't believe we're actually letting Leicester into this game. And if it wasn't for David De Gea, how many times have we said that? Probably would have went in 1-0, because Leicester had a fantastic chance, and you know, it's a brilliant save from David De Gea. I've asked fans today, you know, what they feel about the summer transfer saga that we've had, and lack of signings and lack of activity. Some fans have actually said, you know what, I'm not really too worried. I asked some fans who were sitting around me as well before I even came to the interviews. Some fans are not actually that bothered. They said, look, we've got a good team here. It's down to Jose now to bring the best out of them. And then I spoke to other fans who were completely like, well, where's all the money? You know, they've come out and said that we've made record revenues and we're up, but we haven't seen it invested into the squad. Some other fans have said the board clearly don't back Jose. They don't back him, otherwise they would have got him as targets. I'm a little bit in the middle. I mean, if they trusted him 100%, he would have had his targets. You know, you look at the likes of Liverpool, look at the likes of Man City, and, you know, they're going out and getting the players that they want to fill the positions that they want, and they're going to get it done. With what's going on here, there's whichever way you look at it, whether the board don't back him or whether it was just a bad transfer window, something's not right. It's evident something's not right. But if you're looking at the positive sides of it, like I said already, and I maintained it all the way through last season, we have quality players at the disposal of this club. We've got the likes of Martial, who will probably stay. It looks like he's, you know, almost certainly going to stay because we haven't signed anyone to replace him if we do let him go. So for me, he's staying. Pogba got given the captain's armband today. You know, you've got the likes of Alexis Sanchez in there, Marcus Rashford, Lingard's come back into it. Obviously, Lukaku come off the bench today. Should have bagged. He should have stuck that away to make it 2-0 at the time, but he didn't. But, you know, like I said, we've got players here who can play football. It's just down to Jose and the tactics and the way we play to get the best out of them. Not too much to take from the game, really, because it was flat. It wasn't great. It wasn't the best performance. But I'm not going to sit here after the first 90 minutes of the season and go overboard. It's the first game of the season, and the most important thing, and I repeat, the most important thing is to get 3 points. You know, it's a Friday night. Some players are coming back a little bit rusty and not match fit. And that's the most important thing. And I think I've got to say, Luke Shaw, he got his goal today. I don't know what you guys think. I actually thought he had a good game. No, I'm not saying he was outstanding and head and shoulders above everyone else. But, you know, collectively, I thought we defended well. Eric Bailly and Lindelof did do well as well. But I thought Luke Shaw had a good game. And that goal will do him the world of confidence. Whether or not when Ashley Young's fit, is he going to keep his spot? Only Jose Mourinho is going to be able to answer that question. Luke Shaw's coming for a lot of criticism. I've criticised him in the past, you know, with his fluctuation of weight, maybe his attitude and stuff like that. I've been one of his biggest critics with his mentality. But also last season, though, I'll admit as well, I backed him a lot of times because there were times last season where he had good games and then Jose would just pull him out of the team for whatever reason. So this is a big year for him. I think he's in the last year of his contract, so he hasn't gone. I mean, there's talks of him maybe going to Everton. He stayed and fought for his place. So hopefully he can kick on from that. It'd be very interesting to see what happens with the team selection as players come back from injury. I was absolutely delighted to see Pereira, Fred and Pogba in midfield. A lot of us fans have been screaming for that. I want to know what you guys think. Drop your comments on what you thought of the team selection. Because as players come back, Is he just going to bring Matic straight back in? Is he just going to bring... Well, Valencia will definitely come straight back in. Is Luke Shaw going to lose his place? What's it going to look like in terms of Alexis, Martial? What's going to go on there? Rashford's not going to get too much games up front. We already know that. What do you guys think about the team selection? Because I think that midfield, I think, is the way forward. Yes, there's going to be certain games where you might need Matic. I do believe that. You know, we have to rotate. Pereira's not going to be able to play every single minute of every single game. It's about options. And obviously, when Herrera comes back... he's going to be needed as well for certain games. But I do think we've got more midfield options. And even though we had what you may call a poor transfer window, one thing we did do is bring in the likes of Fred, who, you know, is a direct addressing of one of the areas where we needed to strengthen. I just didn't really get the infatuation with a centre-half, you know. Yesterday at deadline day, I was waiting for something to come over the line. But it wasn't really for an attacking player. It was all out of which one of these five centre-halves in Man United are going to sign. And then we didn't sign any. But that... You know, I thought Bailly played really well today and Lindelof played really well today. So there were some positives in the game, but, you know, for me, I thought the performance could have been better. But we've got, you know, it would have been nice to keep the clean sheet as well, which we didn't manage to get. But all in all, it's 3 points. We go to Brighton next week, Sunday, and we kick on from there. And then we have Spurs back here as a second home game of the season. So it's the first game of the season. No need to overreact. And I don't think any fans have. It's very interesting to get their thoughts on Mourinho and the board and what they've been thinking about the situation, because there are two sides to that, you know. But drop your views in the comments, in the boxes below, guys. It's going to be a long, long season. But like I said, I'm just glad we got the 3 points. Wasn't the best performance, but we got over the line. Thanks for watching.